Jupiter is ready for his close-up.
Hey there, stargazers. I'm James Ulberry, director of the Kika Silva Plot Planetarium in Gainesville, Florida.
And I'm Dean Regas, astronomer for the Cincinnati Observatory. We're here to help you find your way around the sky. The long wait is almost over.
Ooh, is it time for another conjunction?
No, not yet, but soon. Don't worry, don't worry. What I'm talking about is the planet Jupiter.
Uh-huh.
Is at long last getting a new visitor?
Oh yeah, the Juno spacecraft will be arriving at Jupiter on July 4th.
I know. After almost 5 years in space, Juno will finally reach its destination and hopefully bring us some amazing close-up pictures of the giant planet. Why don't we take you there and show you the sights?
Sounds good. Let's take you on a special tour of Jupiter.
Okay, it's July 4th, and we're facing west at 10:30 p.m. There's Jupiter, that really bright star-looking thing. Even though the Earth is moving away from Jupiter, it's still the brightest object in the nighttime sky, other than the Moon.
It looks like a bright, steady, cream-colored star. It was a lot closer to us in March and looked a lot brighter, but now it's almost 540 million miles away. Still, we can see it easily and behold its beautiful light.
So now, we're going to cross those 540 million miles and take you in for a closer look at the giant planet and its many moons.
Faster than the speed of light, we're approaching Jupiter. There, now you can see most of its 67 known moons looking like little fireflies circling the planet. Imagine if we had 67 moons in our sky.
As we get closer, we start to see the planet itself and its telltale stripes, which parallel the lines of latitude on Jupiter. And coming around the side is the Great Red Spot.
The Great Red Spot is a humongous cyclone of gases that well up from the inside and churn the outer surface of the planet. It has been there for at least 140 years, though many other spots have popped up from time to time.
Right now, the Great Red Spot is about the size of two Earths, although it has been shrinking lately. If this continues, the Red Spot may be tough to see, turn pale in color, or disappear altogether.
But Dean, don't get too close. You'll get sucked in.
Well, that was fun.
Good thing we have force fields on our skyboards. Anyway, let's visit each of Jupiter's four largest moons. Io, Europa, Ganymede, and Callisto. These are worlds all their own and have some pretty cool features to explore.
Callisto is the farthest of the four from Jupiter and takes almost 17 days to circle its planet. It's a large moon with a ton of craters. One called Valhalla shows where an impacting asteroid liquefied the rock and left ripples stretching over 2,000 miles.
Ganymede is the largest moon in the solar system. It's even bigger than Mercury. So if it didn't circle Jupiter, it could be a planet.
Next is Europa, the ice-covered world. The surface cracks tell us a story because below the icy shell lies an ocean of liquid water. How much water? Hopefully the Juno spacecraft can tell us more this year. And maybe, in the distant future, we can drill through the ice and see what might be swimming in the ocean below.
And then there's Io. Sheesh, this moon looks a little ugly up close, and it smells. What you're seeing is volcanoes. Volcanoes and more volcanoes peppering the surface. Io is the most volcanic place in the solar system, and Juno will have a great time mapping all the new mountain ranges and lava flows that formed since the Galileo spacecraft last flew by in 2003.
So, on July 4th, celebrate the arrival of the Juno spacecraft to Jupiter.
First, look for Jupiter in the western sky after sunset.
Then, if you can, look through a backyard telescope to see the planet up close and spy four of its 67 moons, Io, Europa, Ganymede, and Callisto.
Then, tune in to the Juno mission to see what discoveries await 540 million miles from Earth. What a journey when you keep looking up.